men are superheroes? And then they look at me and they say, Michael, you're starting to look like a superhero. But I'm going to tell you, in all truth, these are my images of invincible masculinity. Are there other men in this room who are in their 50s or 60s? You remember that, right? These were our images of real men. These are as tough and as strong and as powerful as you could imagine. We could live up to that. If we couldn't live up to this, then think about a boy trying to live up to this. And not only the impossible muscles, look at the difference of an expression between these sort of benign, goofy looks and these looks, I'm going to kill you, you mother of the devil. Who could live up to that? Here's another example. In the U.S., in the 60s, there was this action figure, a soldier action figure for boys called G.I. Joe. G.I. soldiers. That's the original G.I. Joe. And here is G.I. Joe now. I don't know if you can see him, much more evolved. Now, to some extent, these men, this is a basketball player, apparently a water polo player from Singapore, they do sort of look that way because they work out all day, they are on special diets, maybe they do steroids or drugs, I don't know. They sort of look that way. But even then, these pictures then get photoshopped. And if you haven't seen it, when later on Google Dove, you know, like the soap, D-O-V-E, Dove Evolution, or Dove Real Beauty. So what happens, all these feelings bottle up inside men. And for some men, what happens is that they turn to alcohol, they turn to suicide, or they're just unhappy, or they turn to violence. And all these things are because of both the strange combination of men's power and what we think of as men's pain. But when I say that, I want to be clear. This is not making an excuse for a man who uses violence. This is not making an excuse for that. But it is an explanation for the violence. It is an explanation for some of the abusive behavior by some. See who it is. Pass this water down. So, because the thing is, when you look at human genes, not the genes we wear, chromosomes. When you look at human genes, between men, males and females, they're 99.8% the same. We have this expression, at least in English, we talk about the opposite sex. We're not opposite. There's some popular stupid books about men and women from different planets, you know, men are from Mars, women are from Venus. It's all total crap. Because we're not from different planets. Our bodies are mainly the same. But what happens is that we undergo a transformation from birth. Because gender is not just an idea in our head. It actually changes our brains to some extent. We learn to be men and women. And it changes how we walk, how we stand, how we smoke that cigarette. And so all of this is partly why longer, and then we're going to have questions and comments, and then I'll finish my speech at the very end. So let's think about some of the things we can do to bring about change. And there's wonderful things happening all over the world. I mean, right now, during the warm-up, and I think they're going to be playing a rock band called Sisters in Danger. Are you going to be playing afterwards? Yeah. Oh, right. Okay, one more reason for me to finish. they're much better than me, I assure you. I heard them playing. So, a wonderful band. It goes around to schools that not just both performs, but talks to young people, to students, about problems of violence against women, problems of sexism. These are young men who are doing this. And so, all over the world, we see groups of men or groups of men and women who are working together to figure out ways that we can reach men and boys. Remember the paradox. We're challenging men's power, yes. We're challenging men's abuse, yes. But we also have to reshape what it means to be a man. So here's some of the areas that we're doing. First, And so three of us, back in 1991, started a campaign in Canada called the White Ribbon Campaign. But also because we had this incredible tragedy in Canada where a whole number of women were murdered by a man who was...
Yeah, anyway, there's this made a white ribbon on the paper. I have some tape on it. Tape on. So when I wear a white ribbon, or if I put up a white ribbon poster, or have a white ribbon campaign, I'm not doing it to say to you, look what a good guy I am. But I'm wearing this as a public promise. This is a promise I'm making. It's a pledge not to commit, condone, or remain silent about violence against women. Initial form of wrestling, and I just thought, let's get some men together, and we're going to turn it into an signing, a public pledge not to commit, condone, in their own community, how to reach the men and the boys. I can tell you, I can talk for hours. This is my favorite white ribbon picture. And let me tell you about this picture. We know that all over the world, boys who grow up in homes where they see their dad using violence against their mother, those boys are more likely to... The hospital came to take the baby away. And he said, why are you taking my baby away? He said, well, it needs a woman to look after it. And he said, no, it doesn't. I'm going to look after my baby. And here he is driving a bicycle rickshaw with his little baby. Or here's another picture. We're used to seeing very glamorous pictures from the U.S. Here's another U.S. picture. This is what looking after children looks like. It's not always pretty. It's hard work. But this is the work that we need to be doing as men. And of course, when we do it, we feel enormous joy and happiness. Not all the time, because it is hard work and it is exhausting.
Sebagian besar sangat mengerti apa yang tadi disampaikan, tapi ada yang teman-teman juga sudah dapat ini ya, judulnya ini. Ini yang mungkin tadi oleh Michael tidak dijelaskan secara rinci, tapi masuk di dalam cerita dia. Jadi saya hanya ingin menyinggung sedikit saja, dia itu menjelaskan mengenai 7P tentang laki-laki, tentang maskulinitas. Pertama, patriarki, kekuasaan patriarki, tadi sudah dijelaskan banyak ya, yang saya rasa teman-teman paham. Yang lain adalah dengan kekuasaan patriarki itu, laki-laki sebenarnya punya power, tetapi mungkin mereka tidak menyadarinya. Jadi mereka merasa tidak punya power, padahal kekuasaannya besar gitu ya. Jadi hal positif yang akan bisa diperoleh, bukan cuma oleh perempuan gitu ya, tapi yang akan didapat juga oleh laki-laki yang tadi dijelaskan oleh Michael, jadi sehat lebih, karena lebih jujur, lebih apa adanya, lebih bisa dekat dengan anak. Tadi Michael yang dia jelaskan juga bisa mungkin berkuasa sering more. Dan kenapa bisa kayak gitu? Karena perempuannya, jadi kan sekarang banyak perempuan kerja juga ya, jadi terbeban peran yang sangat majemuk dan capean dan kesel gitu. Jadi kalau misalnya kerja bareng itu akan relasinya jauh lebih baik. Nah itu ya teman-teman sekalian. So we are now having all of you to have the turn to ask questions or give comments.
Kecil yang mencoba suka darah itu tidak harus laki-laki. Juga bisa jadi saudara, dan saya pernah memberikan
saya siaran lagi baru membahas tentang maskulinitas. Saya akan menjelaskan lagi yang saya omongi waktu di kelas itu. Saya nggak tahu istilahnya apa, cuman saya melihat seperti ada kayak ini adalah pikiran yang salah, kemudian ada tindakan yang salah, dan yang ini dipercayai, dan hasil dari tindakan ini adalah disebut delusi gitu. Dan bagi saya semua profil laki-laki yang selama ini terbentuk adalah hasil delusi, dan ini tuh termasuk, saya nggak tahu sebutannya apa, tapi seperti kebodohan. Dan kebodohan ini terus-terusan dipelihara, entah karena perempuannya juga tidak memiliki ilmu sampai ke situ, dan laki-lakinya terus mempercayai dengan seperti profil yang dibuat oleh masyarakat. Dan pertanyaan saya adalah bagaimana untuk orang-orang yang ingin mempunyai
should be strong, and they had to be associated with soldiers, with fire, with violence. How did it all start, as first, in the historical society? And second, according to your personal
experience, first, I want to talk about my experience before I ask. So I have this friend, he was an exchange student, and then when he went here, he likes to do all the girls, even slept with many women, and then I was friends with him, and a little different experience. First, I want to talk about my experience before I ask. So I have this friend, he was an exchange student, and then when he went here, he likes to do all the girls, even slept with many women, and then I was friends with him, and a little different relationship with him, and then he always told his friends and also my friend that I had this relationship for a long time, which he was really unsatisfied, that he is very tired and feel like he's in jail due to the fact that
The thing is that last day, actually, my boss was asking, where are you actually going to tomorrow and actually today? I was like, should I say I'm going to talk about gender? Because here in Indonesia, gender often links by, oh, you're gay or something. Well, I am, though. But the thing is that I chose to say I'm going to a seminar talking about manhood.
I think one of the most important things is that we, those of us who are men, have to learn to speak out. And so if we have a friend who is, we think is acting in abusive ways to a partner, it's very scary to speak out. We worry about losing the friendship. We worry, but we also worry about not being real men. You know, oh, is this going to make us look whatever? And so most of us as men are actually scared of speaking out against sexism, against violence, against homophobia, all these different things. So the first thing that we have to do is really push ourselves to speak out.
Considering that you have such a different way of parenting. society where male has more, where men have more power than women. But you can see now women and musicians. I was at your workshop yesterday, and you had us list down a bunch of things, a point of view from a 14-year-old boy, how they see a real man, and those are misguided concepts of masculinity, violence, real men getting into fights, real men have lots of sex. And I feel like I relate to those points, even though I am a woman, except for the penis part. And because I was taught growing up that to be a strong woman, that you have to adopt rules, doing drugs, getting drunk, all that, just to prove that I am not weak, like how I see most women. I begin to see the very, very negative effect of how those values of masculinity affect me.
We'll close the session today. Medcare and its partner, Workers WPF Indonesia, Puli Foundation, Rivka Anissa Yogyakarta, East Java, PKP Lampung, and Aliansi Laki-Laki Baru.
Saya mau yang